going to talk to you about the art of learning, integrating performing arts into science education, and two of the projects that I have done while here at the University of Delaware. So in the general world right now, I feel like whenever you talk about an environmental problem, this is the narrative, right? You say water pollution, and one side says something, and the other side says something else, and there is not really any conversation. It's just a screaming match. But really, there is a little more nuance between there are only two sides of the story. There's research done out of Yale and George Mason that has identified six Americas for global warming. And these different groups can be widely applied to a lot of other environmental issues. There are the alarmed, the concerned, the cautious, the disengaged, the doubtful, and dismissive. And the two sides that we tend to think of as existing are people who are alarmed and people who are completely dismissive. But really, how are we going to engage the other four? Now, these audiences have lower issue involvement than the two extremes. To engage those audiences, you want to provide people with answers to their questions, use visual imagery rather than all of those wonderful graphs and charts that we always see thrown about. You also want to use narratives with character so people can build an emotional attachment with the issue. And also you want to build positive and new social norms. Now, what are some ways that we can do this? Combining science and art, right? Art is wonderful at creating narratives involving emotion, but you can also mix this with the science, with facts.